We're back in the shop. We're about to tear this bitch apart.
She's not a bitch.
Where do we even start? Battery? No, for real, guys, it's been a minute since I did a Subi, but I'm really, really excited because I know there's way less wiring than an Evo, so we pretty much have a wiring connector right about her. We're gonna pop that wiring connector off. We're gonna take off the downpipe, pull off the intercooler, pull off the intake. Thankfully, the whole front of the car is off already, so that's gonna save us some time. I'm guessing within 2 hours, this motor should be out. We'll probably pull the tranny as well, just to check it over, make sure she's good to go. Let's do the thing.
Let's get her done.
I don't even want to start. I just want to take a nap. We're gonna pull out the battery. Damn, how am I supposed to pull a motor if I can't even get the damn battery strap off? Let's remove the battery. Where should our parts pile be?
Over there. I kind of want to clean all of our parts. Is that kind of stupid?
No, I always clean all my parts. Just bend it out of the way.
Now we're taking the air filter off.
Airbox.
Oh, that thing looks kind of junky.
This will be replaced with a fully modified one.
It will?
Probably, someday.
Oh.
Are we gonna keep the bitch stock or what?
No.
I'm gonna do the intercooler right now. Let's do the intercooler. Yeah. That sounds fun.
It's so crunched back there. I've never felt Florida sand before.
Okay.
You tell him, baby. You even broke my finger for that.
What a faggot. Alright. YouTube has to see me at my worst if they want to see me at my best.
Devin's proud.
This car's pissing me off. So I've been trying to pull just the motor itself without the transmission and suspension and all that. And everything is so far pushed back that everything's being such a bitch to get off. Excuse my language, but I don't give a shit.
You're going to bleep that out.
No, I'm not.
Yes, you are.
So what we're going to be doing, guys, is something I should have started just done from the start. We're going to pull off all the suspension, the subframe, the motor, the tranny, all that in one big ass chunk. So it's going to make everything a lot easier. Everything's going to be out. And then when this car goes to the frame shop, the frame rack, we're going to obviously have everything with it, put the suspension back in there so they can make sure everything's aligned properly. But yeah, even trying to get like the turbo heat shield off, it was jammed against the firewall. That right there took an hour. Now, then I was working on the turbo and the downpipe's all jammed up. It's just a nightmare.
No bueno.
I'm just getting pissed off at this car. So break time, slam back a brew, come back, take the shit out. I'm finding a lot more stuff that's bent as well. Like all the shifter linkage is warped like mofo. So we're gonna need that. We're gonna need a new downpipe. We're gonna need the driveline carrier bearing that may be fixable. I don't know, just a lot of stuff. It really makes me sad.
Yeah.
But we'll get it figured out. That's what I did with your Evo 10.
Mm-hmm. I
pulled everything out. It's kind of nice, but then we have to go through doing it this way, we're gonna have to go through and review the brakes, which I guess isn't a big deal. She in a nap.
Come on, baby, let's go.
All right, we took way too long of a break. If you guys follow either of us on Instagram, you probably would have seen one of the live streams. Had a little too many beers, but we're gonna get back to work on the STI. The goal today now, being that it's so late, get the motor and tranny in suspension on the ground. You wanna hold my camera, Haas? As soon as we get our motor and tranny out, we're gonna be done for today, boys. Well, here's the scoop. We have a week until our new front clip comes in. So technically, we have a week to figure out what's going on with the motor.
Technically.
Okay. We have a week to figure out what's going on with their motor and our transmission. Our transmission's Gucci, but our linkage is screwed. Oh, so you think you can dance. All right, put your freaking belly away.
Baby.
Bobby, we gotta get to work.
I know.
So we're gonna pull the freaking whole front end off. All this, the motor, transmission, suspension, coming out. Let's do this thing. If anyone has a power steering pump pulley, Subaru won't sell me one. Unless you got a part number, bang my line. This one's quite warped. Anyways, okay, to pull this engine, up top, we got a lot of the stuff off. We got a master cylinder, or slave cylinder. Ground wire, okay. We have some wiring for the transmission. We have these heater core hoses. So we gotta pull the drive line, and then obviously all suspension. We're gonna unbolt these here, the struts. We gotta pull the ABS line. I know what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna get pretty much everything loose. We're gonna set the car on the ground, and then we're gonna lift the body off of the engine and tranny and suspension. Cause I wanna like make sure as we're pulling everything off that we don't have some wires connected, you know? So we had two options. Option one, disconnect the brake line, bleed the brakes later on. Option two, pull off the caliper from the hub, attach it to the body somewhere so it stays with the car and not bleed brakes later on. It's easier now to pull off just the brake line, but harder later on because we'll have to bleed brakes. So I opted for, as you can see, unbolt the caliper because it's like 2 minutes. So we got 19, 19, and 12 mil and the caliper's done. I'd rather do the hardship now, you know?
Yes.
Because I know when this car's going back together, we're gonna be in such a rush. We're like, oh, let's go fire it up and drive it, mm-hmm. You know? It's gonna be so nice having everything off because we'll be able to tell like what's bent, what's broken. So pretty much all we have left, drain transmission fluid, all the mounts on the bottom, everything up top is done, it's ready to drop out. So we have driveline, tranny mounts, motor mounts, or the whole cross member, and it should drop out. Oh, that's clean. Clean and clear. It must have just recently been changed. Okay, that should be able to dip out below. So right now we're just taking apart the shifter so we can get the shifter out with the transmission. It's just all gonna drop out together. Yeah, we're making some good progress, but this is taking a very long time because everything's so squished. So we have this hoist here just for safety. I'm gonna be crawling under the car. We're gonna take off all of the transmission mounts and the motor mounts. The only mounts that we should really have left when we get the car on the ground are the strut tower mounts. So there's 6 bolts on each side. And we're gonna pull those off and we should be able to jack the car up off the motor and transmission and suspension, roll all this stuff out or drag it up the hoist. Yeah, that's center for the boys. Wish me luck that and I'll not die. So we're gonna use this and a jack on each side. We're just gonna lift pretty much everything up. Can you tell that's the main bolt?
Oh my gosh.
Pretty large, huh?
That thing is massive. Get her out, Hoss.
Thank you.
go. The car. We're good, just keep going up. Oh, my lord. Did I really forget that?
Now would you forget, baby?
I don't even know if I want to say. This is really stupid.
From here, we should be able to jack up the car. The body of the car. Leave that where it is.
Pull it out. You see any wires that are connected still?
Nope. I've never seen a motor on wheels before. I think you can pull it out.
Driver on out.
Why does it look so massive?
There.
Ugh.
That was actually really nice to do it that way. I liked it.
Looks like a turd.
What? Why?
It just looks so much different than an Evo.
Yeah, completely different. Yeah. You have some blocking your leg, but.
They're just crazy looking.
I want to get your motor and trans off the suspension, because obviously the suspension is gonna go back in right now or like soon, because we gotta get to the frame shop. But as far as the frame goes, like nothing's buckled here. You These are always fun when they pop out. I'm gonna have to pull the boot off. Aha! That can never happen. Perfect. Here's what we're gonna do, guys. We're gonna throw this subframe suspension back into the car, get the car on the ground, clean up the shop. Tomorrow, that's the fun stuff. We're gonna pull the tranny off. This tranny, unfortunately, seems a little dick. Like first, second, third, fourth, fifth, all that, or no. Everything works except fifth gear. So I bet they're doing buck 30 in fifth gear and just smash something. I'm sure the tranny itself is fine. It's probably a bent shift fork or something inside. So we'll have to get that fixed. Reverse cable's broken as well. All minor shit. For the most part though, not bad at all. That was easy. Mm-hmm. Let's throw us back in. Send it for the boys. Oh, by the way, the strut is severely bent, guys. Look at this. The scap right here, part of this side, it's like an inch smaller. Just a little FYI, if you're wondering. Here's how the shop is looking. Always a mess at the end of the night. We are gonna end this video with a sick little time lapse of us cleaning the shop. And I'll see you guys bright and early tomorrow.